Everybody, I am the Mademoiselle and this is my channel, and today we're gonna be reacting to another video, but this one is going to be another woman discovering that her man ain't shit. Okay, last time we did one of these, we saw a woman leave her child at the mistress house. Now this video, one of you guys tagged me on Instagram, and let me just tell you guys right now, y'all be tagging me in so many things. A lot of times I don't catch it. It's very rare. Shockingly, I actually caught it this time. So, like I always say, if you have a video that you want me to react to, please put it in the video suggestion box or join the Discord. Put it there. Worst case scenario, maybe DM it to me. Please don't email it. Please don't mention me. Please, because I'm probably not going to see it, okay? It's only by chance that I see it that way, but rarely do I ever, okay? Thank you guys so much for always supporting me. If you guys want to keep seeing my lovely face and you don't see a video on this channel, I'm on one of my other two channels. I have a Haitian channel where I talk about Haitian politics, voodoo, and folklore, and I also have a personal channel where I do advice, routines, vlogs, things like that. Also, if you guys would like to support me more, make sure you guys go join me on Patreon. And if you guys want to be part of the private Discord, that is how you do so. If you guys would like to know how to make really popping thumbnails as creators, I will be doing a live webinar where I teach you guys how to do so. Everything you need is going to be linked down below. That is happening this week. Okay, so if you haven't signed up yet, get it popping, get it going. We're also having a free live, but I'm not teaching y'all shit there. Okay, it's just gonna be a Q&A session. If you guys want to get the tea, the scoops, how to grow your channel, you can also book a one-on-one consultation. But the webinar is mainly gonna be on thumbnails. Everything you need is going to be linked down below. So let's get into it. Now, this video has been going viral, and I'm so happy I could finally watch it with you guys. And let me just say flat out, okay, since we are in the season of love. Okay, it's actually Valentine's Day today, the day that I'm filming this. I am so sorry if any of you guys have ever had to go through something like this, because this is absolutely horrible. I don't understand people who cheat like this to this degree, because it just, like, I just can't fathom. Like it's one thing to cheat and have it be an accident, but it's another thing to cheat and, like, have a whole nother person and, like, just, you know, have someone, like, walk in on you cheating, you know, when you told them that you're supposed to be doing something else, you know. So right off the bat, if this has ever happened to you, I'm so fucking sorry. Because nobody deserves this.
Okay, so my boyfriend's been gone for like 10 days. He has an investment property in North Carolina, so he's been working on the house. They, you know, renovated and gutted it out, so he was there to, like, project manage, and I really, really miss him. And so I'm going to a pop-up to surprise him. So follow me. But first I'm gonna go to Charlotte, hang out with a little cousin. She's having an event, so this just happened to be knocking two birds out with one stone. I'm gonna hang out with her for a little bit, and then he's like an hour and a half away from her, and then I'm gonna go and go. Alright guys, I'm about an hour away, and I kinda think that he knows I'm up to something. Because he called me twice and I was still in the car within the last 2 hours. And I was just like, oh no, I just been running errands all day.
Okay, so first things first, the look is giving. I love the glasses, I love the earrings, I just love the fit. I'm just like, I can't stop looking at it. Second of all, it's the guidance of the spirits, the Lord, the ancestors for me. Girl, you didn't want to surprise him. You just knew something was going on. It's that womanly intuition, okay? That's exactly what that is. But let's see what happens.
Hey guys, so I'm in Charlotte. I'm with my cousin. Say hey, Day-Day.
Hey.
Who would have believed that I would still be at my cousin's house? So guess what? Y'all saw my stories. You see my love story panning out on TikTok. Who would have ever thought that I'd pop up on my boyfriend and his wife answers the door? What? Yeah. He has a whole wife. He's been married. She said they celebrated 7 years. Yeah. And this man's still texting me right now. He couldn't come outside. This woman.
What we give out to us
was like, I was wondering. She said, I was wondering who was blowing in your phone. She was blaming me. Said that I knew. This man has lived a double life. For 5 months we've been together. A double life. This man has pretended to love me and to court me. And we just came back from Vegas. Y'all saw the trip we was laughing and joking about. And I'm so happy that I waited for so many things. And I feel sorry for her because she stuck with him. I'm gone. But the lesson, who would ever thought?
Oh my God.
Kwame. I'm in shock. I was so popping on the love of, supposedly, love of my life. Be careful out here when these men are terrorists.
Wow.
Be careful out here. And pray for me, please.
Bro. What? The wife pulled out a blicky. Hold up, y'all. Let's read this together. So it's a wrap. You texting after I found out you're married and your wife pulled a blicky on me. I asked you, give me an explanation. You let me cry in disbelief and drove off. What you think? Why? Me? I want you. I would come with you right now if you say so. This is trifling. Are you married? 7 years? Okay. No. I want you. Do you want me to come or not? Call me. I'll call you soon. No. Why are you still texting him? Like, okay, we have a lot to discuss here. First of all, I am so sorry this happened to you. I would love to have you on my channel to talk about this because I actually found her Instagram. She is so dope. She is so lit. Like, I really like her. I love her energy. I like her vibe. But I need to understand why you're texting him after that. I want to know why she pulled a blicky on you. I want to know. I have a lot of questions. This sounds crazy. And the wife sounds like this not the first time that she had this go on. Like, she know that her husband trash, okay? She knows that she married the trash compactor, okay? She knows that her niggas for everybody, all right? She knows she a sister wife. She got a community husband. That's community dick, okay? I need to understand. Wow. Wow. Shall we go to the TikTok? Let's go to TikTok. I hope she didn't delete everything already. By the way, shameless plug, go follow me. All right, thank you very much. Anyways. Oh, child. It look like it keep going. Oh my God, it look like it just keeps on going. Oh my God, it just keeps on going. It keeps on going, y'all. We gonna watch it all.
Hey guys, I just got home. And as you see, I'm still having the clothes that I had on. I took a shower and just came straight home. So, no, I didn't, but it's so many layers to the story. This is not me, you know? And it was crazy, my cousin was like, look, your video is like getting so many views. And I'm like, I don't care about that. It was a vulnerable moment and it was an actual moment where I'm living this. This is real life happening right now.
I'm sad.
So it's many questions. There's a lot of questions. I have a lot of answers to give. I probably have to do part one, part two, part three. This is probably a whole series because this is motivation to focus on myself and to focus on the things that I need to focus on, which I was already doing, minding my own business before this man came into my life. And for those people saying, oh, it's only been 5 months. Yes, it has only been 5 months. But this man chased me for a year. I have known him more than the 5 months. This man chased me in courted me and tried to get with me for a year, and I was doing the healing, and I finally decided to give him a chance, and it was beautiful. I can't say one thing.
She about to make me cry.
Besides communication that started lacking in the last month when he started renovating that house in North Carolina. So the pop-up was like everybody saying, like, you knew there's a reason why he popped up. Yes, it was my intuition that I definitely was ignoring in that day. And the crazy thing is that day, even though I was popping up, like, I gotta tell y'all a story. Like, it's when I tell you this is a real Tyler Perry episode, Tyler Perry movie, y'all gonna be like, I'm numb. I drove,
oh,
I
don't even know so how
I got
sad.
To my grandmother's house. I don't even know how I got home right now. So I wanna tell y'all a story. I'm gonna try to get some of it out tonight. But if I don't and I stop and finish later, give me time. This is my real fucking life.
Before we even get into the story, let me just start off by saying, anybody that's sitting there like, oh, it was only 5 months, we do understand that people do, like she said, courting, people do talk, people do have these long relationships before they are official, right? Also, even if it was just 5 months, we cannot just be sitting here deducing people's experiences because we do not know how they feel. Heartbreak hurts, okay? Like, to have your heart broken because someone sat there and courted you for so long and then you find out they're married, it hurts. It doesn't matter if you don't understand. It doesn't matter that it was just such a short amount of time. You don't know what they did in that short amount of time. You don't know how well they got to know each other. You know the moments they shared. You don't know what they exposed to each other regarding their deepest, darkest moments and things like that. So I don't understand why people just be like, oh, well, it's only 2 months. It's only 6 months. It's only a year. Like, no, you don't know what they shared. You don't know how deep it got. I've been heartbroken over people that I've literally only been with for like 6-7 months before.
it's hurt deeper than people I've been with for like over a year. You know, it just really depends on how close that relationship was. I've been more hurt over certain situationships than I have with people that I've actually dated. You know, it depends on the bond that you created with that person. I will say this is probably the first time I've actually reacted to somebody and I actually felt like legit sympathy for her. Like, this is just so messed up. And I can't stand the fact that men will sit here and like chase you, do all of this extra shit, and then they be having a whole other life. Like, we gotta start running the whole facts, ladies. We need to start running the whole facts. We cannot be sitting here letting these men run game on us. We need to start finding out where these men are from, what they be doing, who they done dated, because that's what they do with us. I don't think y'all, like, that's what they do with us. This is why I don't date. Like, back in the day when I was single, I didn't date any man that was from somewhere I didn't know. I didn't date any man that I didn't know at least three people that knew him already, because I need to be able to run the whole facts, because I need to know where you from, what you did, what church you go to, how you clip your toenails. I need to know all that shit, because I need to understand, because there's no way you about to, I already had a man that was married, okay, and was trying to get with me, and I met him at a wedding. I did this whole story time before. Maybe I'll link it down below if I remember the name of it, but like, he was married, I met him at a wedding, and then he was literally like already a month married. Literally only a month married, and you already try to cheat on your wife? That's just fucking nasty. Like, come on now, get your life, get it together. Damn, they cute. Damn, she kept that shit up. Damn, did she just post that recently? Damn, this is really bad. We're getting into part two, guys. Wow, we didn't even watch part one. Sorry, guys. So now we're getting into part one. She has four parts, I believe. So let's get into it.
Okay, so before I go into all the details, which I don't know if I even want to share every single thing because this is wild, I'll go through the day. So as y'all saw in the beginning, that was literally the TikTok of me so happy in the beginning because I was going to surprise him, and I literally had so just missed him. I really just wanted to see him. I was not thinking nothing. So I literally was on my way, was videotaping me on my way to go see him. So which I didn't see, I didn't record, was okay. So the ride there, he kept calling me, so we were on FaceTime, and he literally kind of like, listen, I can't lie to him, our communication as far as talking to each other, we usually tell each other everything. And when I was like driving and he called me the second time, I was still in the car, he was like, where you going? I was like, I want to see my man. And so basically the pop-up turned into him knowing that I was coming, and the plan was I was gonna go to my cousin's house in Charlotte, and his place is an hour and a half away from Charlotte. So of course he was like, hey, I don't want you coming all the way to the mountains, because he lived like further up in the mountains in North Carolina. He was like, and the place is a mess, like all the construction and different stuff because they gutted it out. He was like, I don't want you, you know, here. And he said, I'll meet you in Charlotte and we can go watch the game. And I was like, well, my cousin is her friends are having a Super Bowl party, and then found out my other cousin was doing a Super Bowl party, so he said we can go to one of those. So it was planned. So as I'm heading there, he's calling me throughout the day, but he's saying I'm working on the sink. So he's working on the sink, and I was like, why are you working on the sink and you paid these people to do all this work? So that was first red flag. And so he's like, no, he said, because I want to try to get this together, because I want you to start coming out here. He wants me to start coming out there. Wow, just think about everything. I don't even know what to believe. I don't know what's the lie, what's the truth with this man. So anyways, part two, part three. So anyway, he's working on the sink. So as I'm getting an hour and a half away, which he's an hour and a half away, I was like, won't you? And he's like, well, I'm gonna come so that we can meet there, get there at the same time. Because he missing me, I'm missing him. Like, when I tell you, this man had the biggest smile on his face just knowing I was coming. And first he was like, you're not coming here. When he realized that I really was coming, he was really excited. So I'm like, okay, this turns into a good thing. I'm about to see my baby. I haven't seen him in a couple of, like, 10 days, almost 2 weeks. And I'm like, this is crazy. We've never been apart that long. No matter how much he traveled, no matter how much I travel, we've never been apart that long. So when I get there, I get to my cousin's house, and it's about 4:30, almost 5 o'clock, and I called him, and he was like, he's still at the house working on a sink. What?
I don't understand how these people lead these double lives. So you're telling me he has an entire wife, but you guys were together for an entire 5 months plus. You guys were never apart. Well, how the fuck did he, how did he manage having a wife then? Like, if I had a husband, I'm not letting him sleep anywhere outside of my house while we're married. So I'm trying to understand, like, what did he tell his wife? Maybe it was a career thing. Maybe like he was just like, oh, I'm at work, or I have a job where I have to be away, because I'm trying to understand what type of lie do you give your significant other to hold that will allow you to literally hold a significant other life like this that no one's gonna question? Ciao.
So that was like weird to me, but I was like, well, he really wants to start getting the house together so that I can start coming out there so we don't be apart too long, whatever the case may be. Because he said, after he starts getting it done, he'll be back in Atlanta. Because he has an apartment out in Atlanta too, so he says. And then he would be like visiting me. So I get to my cousin's house, it was like 4 o'clock. And like 4:15, and I called his phone, and he was like, babe, I'm almost done. And he was outside, and I thought that was weird that he was outside. And he was like, I'm trying to find this pipe to turn the water off because I done did something, I done messed something up. And I said, that's why you shouldn't left it alone, you should have been messing with it. And you know, I'm just laughing and I said, your girl is an hour and literally 15 minutes away from you, and you were at a sink for something that I'm not even gonna see for a while. Bring your behind. And so he's like, I got you. So he's like, I'll be to you. So he was like, I'm gonna call you back. So then I'm standing, I'm talking to my cousin, we laughing, kiki and catching up. And he texts me and he's like, I'll be to you around 7. And so I show my cousin, we both go, what? 7? It was like, what? Like, I haven't seen you in 10, 11 days. I'm an hour away, hour and 15 minutes away. You were about a sink that you're supposed to be paying other people to do first. That was weird, really weird. So mind you, he stopped the pop-up, so I was popping up. I literally was at my cousin's house waiting. So I was like, well, I'm tired, I'm gonna take a little nap. I said, you better be here by 7. No. So at 5:39, I can remember, like, because I'm gonna show you the text messages, he literally texted me. He was like, babe, I got so scared, something happened, water leaking everywhere, I had to call somebody to come and help. And he's like, please give me a second, I promise I'll be there. So I'm like,
bullshit. At that point, I would've knew something was up. Okay, no.
Excuses is getting weird now. And so I'm like, what's going on? And so,
bullshit.
I'm shaking, cause like, woo, sigh. So that was the last text message, was at 5:39. So about like 6:30, he's supposed to be there at 7. 6:30, I called him back. He did not answer the phone. It's like, what? Why you not answer the phone? Since when you don't answer the phone for me? And now everything is, all the math is mapping up. The times that he fell asleep, the times that his phone died. It's like all the stuff, like you, the things that you don't pay attention to is all starting to math up. So anyway, you're not answering the phone. So I'm weirded out now. I'm so close. It's not like I'm in Atlanta. I'm right here at this point now. You're about to hit the pop-up.
We here with it. I'm sorry, as soon as he would have said that, I'm coming with sisters, brothers, cousin, uncles, parents coming, everybody coming. He busting down doors. We're doing all that because no, now you're playing in my face. Okay, now you take me for dumb, you took me for stupid. Okay, you think I'm an idiot. I don't have time for that. That shit doesn't even make any sense. It's the sink thing for me. Like, you're supposed to be paying people to fix this shit, but you're fixing it yourself, and then you're making all these excuses. Oh man, bless your heart, you do not deserve this.
I have a major headache. I had to stop because I was crying. This is a lot, and I think I'm doing too much trying to get this all out. I'm going through it, I realized that I don't have enough closure, and I probably need to give myself a little bit more time. But anyway, part three, I go through his phone. I mean, I look, and 6:30, he's not there yet, and it's not sitting right with me, because what right man who's in a good relationship, a happy relationship, and haven't seen his girl in 10, 11 days, doesn't come to see them, and they're only an hour and 15 minutes away. So everybody's asking, like, how did I get the address? Why would I have the address to his house if that's so-called his wife? I'm asking myself the same thing. I did not have the address. So we have this thing where we share each other's locations. The reason why we share each other's locations is he's always traveling, and I'm always traveling. And then since he was in North Carolina, that was a way for us to keep, you know, in contact with each other and know that we were going to be okay.
You're always sharing each other's locations, but he was never at the wife's house? Nobody thought to Google or Earth each other's address? I don't know.
That day, he had turned his locations off. So I had definitely saved it. And I could not find the location, but I knew in the vicinity of where he lived. And I had a picture of the house. So mind you, he was building a dream that this is, he's fixing up this house. This is something he's going to rent out, investment property. But of course, before you rent it out, he's going to be staying there. So of course, I'm going to be seeing it and coming up there to visit until he rents it out or whatever he's going to do with it. So this is something I'm building, a life with this man. This man has said he wanted to marry me. This man has done soft proposals. This man have looked at rings with me. This man has sold this dream completely. And it wasn't a dream to me. This is a dream. This feels like a dream to me. This doesn't feel like reality. This feels like, it doesn't even still feel real. Jesus. So anyways, I go try to find a location. I can't find a location. So my behind picks up the phone and I find the location from the picture that he sent me of the house. Don't ask me how I got it. That was all God. That was all my ancestors letting me know. And I literally found it down to the number, the block, everything on the house or whatever. But y'all already knew the block. He already told me. He's never hid anything from me. So I never had a question to question that this man was. I don't even know if he's married. Like, the story gets so deep. So anyway, this man said that he's not married. This man's still been texting me. This man's still been calling me. I'm so confused. Literally just got off the phone with him. I'm not going back. I'm not. My mother's like, you're gonna go back. And I was like, it's my decision to, I don't know what I'm gonna
do. Oh, it's more. Let us go read the text message. Is this the same text message we read? Okay. Oh no, okay, this is the same text message we read. Let me just, this is the thing, right? She's talking about soft proposals. She's talking about going ring shopping with the man and all of that. Understand, right? I understand we all like to put out this idea that men know what they want. They go after what they want. If they love you, they'll say it. If they want you, they'll go after you. This is all 1000% true. However, there's a such thing as niggas literally just doing whatever it is that they can to prove to you that they want you and more than likely love bombing you in order to get in your good graces, to abuse you, to use you, to literally have you there at their beck and call. And this is probably a good example of that. Let's be very, very like realistic here. It is very rare for someone to legitimately fall in love and be with you after 5 months and like be ring shopping with you and all of that, like after only 5 months. Yeah, you can fall in love. Yeah, you can be in a committed relationship. I think that's very feasible, but ring shopping and all of that, and ooh, that's a little ooh, it just sound like it progressed a lot. Okay, like I remember in the last video she was talking about how they just came to Vegas and all of that. It's like most of the time mature established men who like know what they want, when they are with the woman that they want to be with, they know that they want it to last, so they are pretty patient. They're not gonna waste the woman's time. Like, they're not gonna sit there and make you wait 7 years for a ring, but 5 months going ring shopping is a pretty big red flag. Now, I understand everybody has different timelines for different things, but hearing all of this and then looking back at it, it is a bit concerning, okay? I've talked about this on my third channel. That's where I do like advice videos and things like that. I made a video recently about why nice guys always hurt you, why like you always seem to be picking up these guys that seem to be great, that say that they're great, that say that they'll never hurt you, but then they always end up hurting you. And it's because a lot of guys just ignore common sense things. And this is one of those very big common sense things. These are the guys that are like, oh, I would never do this, I would never do that. They're holding doors and they're texting you good morning and good night, and it's like, nigga, this is what they're supposed to do. And another thing I mentioned is these are the men that love bomb you. They throw everything at you, they give you everything you need, they give you all these things that you've been looking for, but you need to step back and be like, wait, this isn't fucking normal. For example, I had a friend, she was dating a dude that out of nowhere was so fucking eager to like pay her rent after dating her for like 2 months. That's not normal behavior. Yeah, that's something that'd be great, that's something that would be nice, but unless that man is already making like maybe in the $1 million type of tax bracket type shit, that's not normal for someone to just be paying your rent after 2 to 3 months. I know y'all want to be city girl so fucking bad, y'all want to act like, you know, y'all got it like that and y'all so damn pretty and y'all pussy so amazing that a nigga should be bending backwards over for y'all, but to be quite honest with you guys, that's not realistic. Okay, a lot of you guys have a very unrealistic mindset as to what a man and what a woman should provide for you. So sadly, when things like this happen, y'all just like, yes, finally what I'm supposed to get. And it's like, no, a lot of this is actually kind of unrealistic. So I mean, I feel bad because a lot of people probably wouldn't even peep game like this, but if a nigga trying to take me shopping for a ring after 5 months, talking about marriage is not too big of a deal, but the ring shopping, like, it just thinking about it all, I'm like, just a lot. But that's just my personal opinion. But also that has a lot to do with age as well. Like, clearly if you're like in your 30s, 40s, what are we wasting time for?
I woke up this morning thinking that I was feeling better.
Aww.
I don't know why I'm hitting from this. But I woke up this morning angry. People were saying, like, I'm looking at some comments and I'm like, oh, you probably just wanted sex. No. In the 5 months we was together, we didn't start having sex until like the fourth and fifth month. When we went to Vegas, I made him like wait, and then we had just started, like we did something when we went to Vegas. After him waiting, he was a gentleman. This man, he knew that I didn't want to just sleep with him. He knew that I wanted to, like, he felt, he...
That's sad.
He knew that I wanted love first. This man carefully loved on me. This man came, took care of my mom when she was not feeling well, came and cooked for us. This man is not my grandmother. This man has been around my family.
Wait, why, ladies, gentlemen, dogs, and cats, do not bring anybody around your family until you know you're very close to marriage? Like, on some real shit. Don't. Like, on some real shit. If you know y'all arguing like cats and dogs, don't bring them near your parents. If you know damn well you can't even spell their last name, don't bring them to your parents. If you know that you can't run a whole fax, don't bring them to your parents. If you don't know their credit score, don't bring it. Say no. I'm trying to tell you guys, don't just be bringing anybody to your parents. 5 months dating seriously and you're bringing them to your parents? Yes, I understand you guys were probably courting and dating before that, but like bringing them to your parents, like, I understand you guys probably had a really deep connection, but this is a little absurd now, okay? And I can tell you love deeply. This girl loved deep. I wish I could love this deep, but my senses won't let me. No, this man is crazy. This man is conniving. What? He waited for sex. He took care of your family. He met your family all within 5 months. Where was the time for the wife? Is it really a wife? I'm beginning to think it's not a wife. Because how could this man be so involved with you while having a wife? Right, Sage.
He's been at my shows, supporting me publicly.
I don't know, bruh.
This man has intertwined his life. He's putting himself in my life with intentions of saying I was his future wife, and all the time he already had that. When I got to that house and she was so angry, she cursed him out. I never told him that way. We talked to each other, king and queen. We called each other king and queen every day. That lady was angry. That was 7 years of hurt. When she pulled that gun out on him and then she pointed it at me, I wasn't even scared. I was so hurt.
A nigga, what? First of all, see, you're better than me. I would've went to the police station. Everybody going to jail. Everybody going to die. Because y'all got me fucked up. You know, I don't give a fuck what's going on. I don't give a fuck about your hair. I don't give a fuck about your 7 years of marriage. You're not pulling out no damn guns on me. Fuck is you talking about? First of all, that's why you cheating on her. Because who does that? What the hell is wrong with you? You're going to jail. That's assault with a deadly weapon. I know you didn't do nothing yet, but attempted assault with a deadly weapon. Threatening something. I don't know. I'm not a cop. But I know that's a charge. You can't be doing shit like that.
I was standing outside crying, stepped back from the porch. I didn't want to be on her porch. Out of her respect, that lady said that was her house. That lady said those were her two cars. She said this is her shit. This man's lied to me. I don't know what to believe.
They said he's not married.
I mean, that lady is probably the mother of all his children, everything. But she pointed the gun at me. I don't even think her anger was towards me, but she did point it at me. But I was so far back. This man wouldn't even come outside. When he came outside, he got in his car and he drove off. He said he drove off to protect me, because if he probably would have came to me, she probably would have shot both of us. But he drove off, and I went and I got my car right after that. This lady thought that I was gonna bring people to, like, I'm so angry and hurt. I would never. He can't even touch me with a 10-foot pole. I'm done. I'm done.
You're telling me this man cowardly drove off and left you there with the crazy ass wife, baby mother, side chick? We don't know what the fuck's going on here. Who is she? Why is she got a... What is going on? Yo, this man is basura, bro. Nah, everybody's going to jail. I'm sorry. See, this is the thing. God knows not to put me in these crazy ass situations, because I'd make a bag off of it. Second of all, everybody's dying. I am turning everybody into a goat, okay? I don't practice, but I'd start practicing today, and everybody's turning into a goat, a pig, a chicken, all that shit. Get my money. Fuck all that. Like, it's the fact that he left you there crying with no explanation. It's the fact that he left you there and he tried to be like, oh, well, I left you there because, you know, she would have shot us both. To be honest, that could have really been a bad situation, though. She really could have shot you. I need to understand what the logic here was. I don't even. We skipped the whole part of the story. What happened? happened? We skipped the whole part of the story here. I want to know the shit leading up to that. Come on, girl. How you gonna leave us like with a whole gap in the story?
Seeing and finding the wedding pictures. It just...
You found the wedding pictures?
I don't know. This man, everything he told me was a lie. Come on now. I deleted so many. I got angry the other... Like, when it first happened, I started deleting some TikToks before I left some of them. So yeah, I'll be seeing some of the TikToks. This man has also been at my shows with my friend. This is gonna be my last day of crying.
This is so sad.
I really believe, like, yo, did he really think that, part of me was like, he really was all over my page and he was living this happy life because he really wanted to start all over with me. But you... She said they celebrated 7 years, everything that woman said. I wish I could talk to her. I wish I can and I don't care anymore. But she can't do this to someone else. I'm only doing these posts so I can save another woman from this evil person.
Jesus, this is sad as hell. This is sad as hell.
I told this man that God didn't play about me. And I guess he didn't fear God.
Let me just say, straight up, like on some real shit, the vulnerability that people have on TikTok is admirable. Because yes, people cry on Instagram. Yes, people cry on YouTube. Yes, people cry on Twitter. Not the way they cry on TikTok. People definitely put all their business out, lay their hearts out on TikTok like no other platform. First of all, I need to follow this girl because Jesus Christ. But people really do lay out their entire lives on this app for everyone to see, to critique, to comment on. There is something admirable about it. You know, there is something interesting about it. There is something good to say about it because on one end, we get to see people for who they are. We get to see people at their best, at their worst, no filter, you know? And I think that's a really amazing quality that a lot of people have, like their ability to essentially get on the internet and be like, listen, I don't feel well, I don't like this, this is what happened to me, I want to save you guys from having the same experience. It's very different. Like, that's what's very unique about TikTok. I will say, even though she's basically trying to stop people from having this experience with this man or practically any other man, I will say straight up, y'all need to not do this type of shit, because it does not look good in terms of like sitting here putting your hurt on the line like this over heartbreak, right? It's one thing to tell your story. It's one thing to resonate with people. It's one thing to just cry. Crying is one thing, but this is wailing. Like, you're literally wailing, like wailing. And for the most part, it does make it look like you're wailing over a man. And that's what people are gonna deduce it to. And sadly, TikTok is brutal. That's one thing I don't like about TikTok. People on TikTok are rude as shit. People on TikTok don't give a fuck about your feelings. They don't give a fuck about what you're going through. And they're probably going to deduce everything that you're saying to absolutely nothing. And they're going to make it seem like, oh, well, you ain't said nothing that we didn't already know. And you're literally crying over a man. And it was only 5 months. You need to get the fuck over it. Da, 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 da. Clearly, some people are going to receive it if the message is received by whoever needs to receive it. That's all that really matters. But you need to be aware of the messages that you put out there and the actions you use to put the messages out there, if that makes sense. Because to be honest, especially when it comes to Black women, they try to ridicule us and make us feel small every way they can, okay? But to be honest, I feel like the videos were very admirable. I feel like they were raw and I feel like they were needed in a way. I like the fact that she still has his face out there. So now we can see, okay, if this man ever talked to us, we know, okay, boom, don't talk to him, boom, he's a womanizer, boom, he's a liar. In regards to the story, I'm not even gonna lie, part of me does low-key feel like maybe, just maybe, he was gonna leave his wife and go try to be with her. That does not excuse what he did. You have have an entire wife or a girlfriend or whatever the case may be, you have another woman, you do not go and pursue a whole other woman when you have a woman already. That is disgusting. That's a horrible thing to do. It is dishonest, and it's not the way you go about starting a new relationship. You leave that one person and then you move on to the next one. What he did, if that's what he was trying to do, was definitely messed up on all levels. The fact that he is still trying to contact her, trying to say he doesn't have a wife and all of that, I don't know what that really means, but whether he has a wife or not, I need her to not go back to this man. I really hope she doesn't, because at this point, you're done outed him, you're wiggling over this man on social media, you're warning us about this man, and then on top of that, the ex, the wife, the whatever, the side, we don't know what it is, has pulled the blicky on you. So it's not safe. Regardless of what she is to him, she clearly has laid ownership on him, and she ain't fucking around. So I need you to not fuck around with your life, okay? So of course, comment down below, have you had any similar situations? What would you do in her situation? And most importantly, would you ever lay out your situation this publicly on social media? Because personally, I've been there, done that, would never do some shit like that again, okay? With my ex situation, yeah, I was the wailing, annoying, doing all of that, and personally, I don't think anything good came of it. To this day, I do not have a Snapchat because I practically did what she did, but on Snapchat, and it was not pleasant, okay? To this day, like I said, I still do not have a Snapchat because I am embarrassed, okay? To be honest, I feel like she's brave for what she did, you know? And people go about things different ways, people grieve different ways. I would definitely love to talk about her. I would definitely love to talk to her, like, even if it's just in private, not on my channel, like, because I think, like, she's just really cool. I followed her. She just has a really nice vibe, and she sings pretty well. But anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you guys so much for always supporting me. Make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that. Follow my other two channels. And of course, peep the description box for everything that you guys consistently ask me about down below. With that being said, I'ma see y'all next time. Bye!